Now come to your topic, linear equations with constant coefficients, means linear differential equations with constant coefficients. Here we will study linear differential equations with constant coefficients of second order. See, a general linear differential equation with constant coefficients will be of the type dny by dxn plus p1 dn minus 1 by dxn minus 1 plus p2 dn minus 2y by dxn minus 2 plus 1 plus pny is equal to capital S. Here p1, p2, so on, pn, these are constants and x is the function of x only. Then we say it as the linear differential equation with constant coefficient. For n is equal to 2, it will be linear differential equation with constant coefficients of second order. So for solving this type of equations, we need to find two things. First, complementary function, and second is your particular integral. Complementary function is found when x is equal to 0, and particular integral when x is non-zero. So see here, symbolic representation. In symbols, we can write the above equation as dn plus p1 dn minus 1 plus p2 dn minus 2 plus 1 plus pn y is equal to 0, where d1 is your d by dx, d2 is your d2 by dx2, and so on, dn is your dn by dxn. This is an operator, and it is equivalent to this one, d is equal to d by dx, and so on. First case equation with right hand member x is equal to 0, this should be capital X. So here we will need to find auxiliary equation. Suppose the differential equation with x is equal to 0 be this one. Put the right hand side equal to 0. Then we need to find its auxiliary equations. And auxiliary equations are found by substituting this equation in this form: dn plus p1 dn minus 1 plus p2 dn minus 2 plus 1 plus pn, and y equal to 0. So within bracket is the operator operating on y. Here in the bracket, we will substitute d by m. So it will be a polynomial of nth degree. Evaluate the values of m. See here. See here, formation of auxiliary equation. So the differential equation is written as this one: dn plus p1 dn minus 1 plus p2 dn minus 2 plus 1 plus pn y is equal to 0, where dn is dn by dxn. So it will be fdy is equal to 0, where fd is dn plus d to p1 d to the power minus 1 plus p2 d to the power minus 2 plus 1 plus pn. So after substituting, replace d by m. So it will be m to the power n plus p1 m to the power minus 1 plus p2 m to the power minus 2 plus 1 plus pn equal to 0. So it will be fm is equal to 0. Now we need to find the values of m for this equation of nth degree. It is obtained by replacing d by m. Now see the method how to find the complementary function. See, we shall now consider the method of finding complementary function of a given equation. It will depend on the nature of the roots of the auxiliary equation. Suppose this is your auxiliary equation, so it will have roots of different types. See what are the types. First, the roots are real and equal. First thing. Second, the roots are real. First, roots are real and unequal. Second, roots are real and equal. Third, roots are conjugate complex, not repeated. And fourth, roots are conjugate complex and repeated. So these four rules we will discuss one by one. See the first. Suppose our fm is equal to 0 can be written as phi m into m minus m1. So here roots are real and unequal. So m minus m1, it is the root is m1 and it is only one time, so it is unequal. So it can be written as fd is equal to phi d into d minus m1. So see here, y is equal to c to e to the power m1x is a part of the complementary function. Since here d minus m1 equal to 0 will give you d is equal to m1, or m minus m1 is equal to 0 will give you m is equal to m1. So the one part of the complementary function is y is equal to c e to the power m1x. Suppose if m1, m2, m3, and so on, mn, these be the different roots of the auxiliary equation fm is equal to 0, then the complementary function will be given as c1 e to the power m1x plus c2 e to the power m2x plus c3 e to the power m3x plus 1 plus cn e to the power mnx. depending upon the degree of the auxiliary equation fm. It will be clear with the following example. See example 1. d2y by dx2 minus 5dy by dx plus 6y is equal to 0. So the auxiliary equation will be what? M square minus 5m plus 6 is equal to 0. See, you need to replace d by dx by m and d2 by dx by m square. So it is m square minus 5m plus 6 equal to 0. This is our auxiliary equation. And it can be written as m minus 2 and m to m minus 3 is equal to 0. Factorize this one. So it will be this. It means from this values of m are 2 and 3. So the complementary function will be c1 e to the power 2x plus c2 e to the power 3x. So here, since the right hand side member is 0, so the general solution will be y is equal to c1 e to the power 2x plus c2 e to the power 3x. See another example. d2y by dx2 minus dy by dx minus 2y is equal to 0. See here again, the auxiliary equation will be m square minus m minus 2 equal to 0. So this is our auxiliary equation. So it can be factorized as m plus 1 into m minus 2 is equal to 0. It means m is minus 1 and 2. So the part of the complementary function will be c1 e to the power minus 1 and 2x plus c2 to the power 2x. Since y x part is right hand side is 0 here, so the general solution will be y is equal to c1 e to the power minus x plus c2 e to the power 2x. As in another example, see this one. This is a differential equation of third order. So here the auxiliary equation will be m cube plus 6m square plus 11m minus 6 equal to 0. Here it should be plus. So I factorize this one. So it will be m minus 1, m minus 2, and 2 minus 3 is equal to 0. It means the values of m are 1, 2, and 3. It is not a tough task to factorize this one. So I'm not going to deal this one. So the complementary function will be c1 e to the power 1 into x plus c2 e to the power 2 into x plus c3 e to the power 3 into x. And therefore, the general solution will be y is equal to c1 e to the power x plus c2 to the power 2 plus c3 to the power 3x. Since here, right hand side member x is 0 here. See one more rule. Roots are real and equal. Suppose the auxiliary equation, in auxiliary equation, m1 is a root and repeated twice. Means it comes two times. So fm can be written as psi m m minus 1 whole square. Therefore, fd will be psi d fd minus m1 whole square. From here, after equating this to 0, you will get m is equal to m1 m1 and psi m is equal to 0. But for m is equal to m1 m1, the part of the complementary function will be written as c1 plus c2x e to the power m1x. See here, for a repeated root m1, the part of the complementary function is c1 plus c2x e to the power m1x. This remains the same, but here the coefficient becomes different. It will be c1 plus c2x. Similarly, if m1 is repeated three times, then the part of the complementary function will be c1 plus c2x plus c3x square e to the power m1x. So keep this in your mind. See the one example. d2y by dx2 minus 6 dy by dx plus 9y equal to 0. So this equation can be written as m square minus 6m plus 9 equal to 0. So its solution will be m minus 3 whole square is equal to 0, means m is 3, 3. It means repeated root. So for this repeated root, you will have complementary function c1 plus c2x e to the power 3x. So this is for another example. So we will see it later on. See here, rule 3 also we can see. Roots conjugate complex and not repeated. Suppose one root is m1 is equal to alpha plus I beta and another root m2 is equal to alpha minus I beta. Then the complementary function will have e to the power alpha x a cos beta x plus b sin beta x. It can also be written as in the form k e to the power alpha x cos beta x plus phi. So see it, and also there is one more rule. Roots conjugate complex and repeated. See, suppose alpha plus I n minus beta, alpha plus minus I beta, this is our root, conjugate complex root, and it is repeated r times. Then the coefficient here, see here, the coefficient of cos beta, this is a and b, will be changed as per here written a1 plus a2s plus 1 plus ar x to the power r minus 1 and b1 plus b2r plus 1 plus br x to the power r minus 1 sin beta x cos beta x and u power alpha x, they will remain at the same position. With one example it will be clear. See, d2y by dx2 plus 4y is equal to 0. So auxiliary function equation will be m square plus 4 is equal to 0. It means m square is minus 4, so m will be plus minus 2y. See here, the roots are complex, conjugate complex, but not repeated. So its solution will be e to the power alpha into x. See here, alpha is 0, since alpha plus I beta should be, but alpha is 0 and beta is 2. So e to the power alpha is e to the power 0 into x, within bracket c1 cos beta x, so c1 cos 2x plus c2 cos sin beta x plus c2 sin 2x. So the general solution is y is equal to c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. Since here x is 0 here, so it is the general solution. As another example, you can see another example also. It will be our last example for today. d2y by dx2 plus dy by dx plus y equal to 0. See, the auxiliary equation will be, this equation is of linear differential equation of second order with constant coefficients. So auxiliary equation will be m square plus m plus 1 equal to 0. Solving this one, we get m, the values of m will be minus b, here b is 1, so minus 1 plus minus under root b square means 1, minus 4 ac, 4 into a is 1 and c is 1, divided by 2 into a, 2 into 1. So 2, it is, it means it is minus 1 plus minus, this is your 3, minus 3, but with under root 2, it will be root 3i by 2. So real part is minus 1 by 2, means it is alpha, and imaginary part is root 3 by 2, so it is beta. The root is conjugate complex and not repeated. So the general solution will be y is equal to e to the power minus alpha x, e to the power alpha x, so it is minus 1 by 2x, within bracket c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x, so c1 cos beta x means root 3 by 2x plus c2 sin root 3 by 2x. So this is not a tough one. You can very easily solve all of the problem. And if you have any difficulty, you can ask me here or on my WhatsApp number or on my